So now, according to several people, the kid, the young man that we quoted yesterday, Mr. Gomez from the Dominican Republic.
Hector Gomez.
Hector
yes.
Gomez said that Yankees are out for Machado, that it's between the White Sox and the Phillies.
Mm-hmm.
Don't know if that's true. I don't know if the Yankees are out. Yankees, from every report I've heard and people I have not even made an offer to him.
Right. So how can they be out if they haven't made an offer?
Right. Because what if they swoop in and go, you know what? Whatever you want,
buddy. But then again, if you told me they didn't make an offer, then you can make the case they're not in. If you didn't make an offer, then you're not in.
Unless Lozano, his agent, said, we got to start at 10 and 300 or... And the Yankees know they're not going there.
Well, I think it's clear the Yankees don't want to go there. So if the White Sox and the Phillies are willing to go there, then just logic would tell you the Yankees are out. Are the Yankees going to change their mind? Are they going to have like a Teixeira moment and say, now we have to have this guy, let's climb back in?
To get to 10? No.
No.
Maybe they push it to 8, although I doubt that. Now, I would not have a big problem. Let's say they really want this guy, and they say that this is the guy that's going to put them over the top. 10 years for a 26-year-old is not hideous. I'm sorry, it's not. Do you want them? I understand drawing line. They probably went beyond what they wanted to do. They offered a 7-year deal to Robinson Cano.
Yes.
And he was 31.
Right.
So that would have taken him to 38. If you give Machado a 10-year deal, he's going to be a free agent again at 35.
I never really looked at that 7-year offer as being realistically taken. I always thought that was...
But what if he took it?
But I don't think he would have. I think they knew. You know, listen, the Yankees are smart. They knew he signed up with Jay-Z. Jay-Z wanted to get him the 10 years. He wanted the 10 years, all right? Yankees threw out the 7, which ironically they ended up giving to Ellsbury. Right. So I guess they might have been willing to take Cano had he dared them or called their bluff. But I think they knew he wasn't going to take it. It was a PR move to say, hey, we like Robinson Cano. We'll bring him back at 7. But I thought they never realistically thought that Cano would take it.
Well, I think that with these contracts, you look, can we get, like, if you offer a 7-year deal, can we get 5 good years out of him? Then they'll amortize it, and they'll live with the final 2 years when he's bad. So if Cano had taken a 7-year deal, well, one of the years would have been half obliterated because of the PED suspension, so they'd save that money.
Yeah.
And I bet you, and when he came back, he had 318, and I bet you year 6 and 7 are not going to be awful for him. It's years 8, 9, and 10 that the Mets are going to have to deal with.
Right. But they're willing to do that.
Right.
Oh, by the way, Daniel tweets Cabrera got 10 years with the Tigers.
Terrible.
That was horrendous.
Horrendous. But again, that wasn't a free agent deal because it was an extension. That's
right.
Why I didn't include
but
that.
But even the extensions don't work necessarily.
One of the best 10-year deals was Jeter's that he extended. He gave the Yankees everything they could have wanted.
All right, so if you include extensions, we came up with one guy. Who else
Joey Votto's deal isn't bad. I mean, it's hamstrung that team, but Joey Votto is a pretty good player.
He's a good player, but if it hamstrings your team, like you said, part of the reason you thought that Pujols was horrendous is because it hamstrung the Angels.
Right, but
it's doing it to the Reds.
But it also hamstrings, Votto hasn't hamstrung them on the field. Pujols does. He can't play the field.
Well, that's why it's
bad. He can't run.
But
he's a shell of a player.
He's averaging 30 and 100 over the 6 years he's been there. That's not terrible.